survey says it's 6 o'clock, time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
Family Feud, hope you had a wonderful weekend. We've been out right across Australia asking people all sorts of fun questions, and now it's time to see if two families can guess the answers to win a load of cash or maybe even a brand new car. Now, on Friday night, the Porter family took home that fantastic Mitsubishi Outlander and over $16,000 in cash. So tonight we've got two brand new families. In fact, have we given away some cars lately? We were giving off like 3 cars in 6 days or something. I felt like Oprah. You get a car, you get a car. We all get a car. Let's meet the Hutton family. How are you, mate?
Very well.
Great to have you with us.
Thank you for having us.
Who's on board your team?
I have my other half, Trudy, my brother-in-law, David, and my sister down the end, Natasha.
Lovely to meet you guys, and best of luck, and ready to take them on tonight. It's the Ropata family. Lovely to have you with us. Would you mind introducing us to your stunning team?
This is my daddy, Stuart.
Is that Dwayne Johnson? Is that The Rock? Stuart, are you
daddy.
The Rock?
I'll just go by daddy.
Okay.
And my sister-in-law, Stephanie.
Hello. Beautiful. Great to have you guys on board. Righto, team captains, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name something you associate with a skateboard. Jeremy.
Wheels.
Wheels.
What do you reckon?
I'm going to say indie boys.
Indie boys? Yeah. No, not. Jeremy, pass or play?
Coming over here. How are you, Stu?
I'm very well, thank you.
Good to see you.
Likewise.
You window dance, do you, when you're drunk, Stu?
Which is a very, very rare occasion.
Yeah, what is it? Explain.
Well, normally, by the time I do get drunk, or intoxicated, as we like to say, I'm outside, everybody's inside.
Yeah.
So I have nobody to dance with but my reflection in the window.
So just sort of shimmy and a shake
I'll
with yourself
there.
And you go...
Yeah, I'll go there.
You're a handsome devil, you're doing a great job there in the window. Love your moves.
Yeah. Got some. Yeah. Not many, but some.
You've got to appreciate yourself. Something you associate with a skateboard?
A skate park.
Skate park's good. Yeah. Tari.
Hello.
Name something you associate with a skateboard.
We're having... teenage boys myself, I'd say teenagers.
Teenagers. She left you hanging there.
I was like, oh, hello.
I'll do it.
Thank you.
Something you associate with skateboard?
I'm going to have to say ramps. The ramp.
Let's have a look. Yeah. Nice. Ramps is good. Micah, something you associate with the skateboard.
I can't skate, but I know there's skating brands, so I'm going to say skating stores.
Skating stores at the place where you buy your skateboard.
Yeah, you're close.
No, first strike of the break.
Stu? the helmets. Helmets.
Helmets.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're tracking along really well here. Only 2 left on the board. That's a great position in the opening part of this show, so well done.
Thanks. I'm going to go with similar line with the helmet, so the protective, like, knee pads, shin, you know, all those elbow pads.
Let's see.
Protective clothing.
Second strike. So the Huttons could steal, so time to have a think, team. Stephanie.
OK. Broken bones.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Let's have a look. Lovely position to be in, team captain. Just 1 left. What is it?
It's going to be on the board.
Good.
And the answer is...
You're not talking.
Beaches. Skate on the beach.
You
do.
You mean like kind of like on the boardwalks around the beach. We want beaches. Beach. Sorry. Righto, Natasha.
Tony Hawk.
Excellent. The skateboarding god.
Tony Hawk.
Excellent. Trudy.
I'm going to try and come up with something original. What about the tricks that the skaters do?
Skate tricks. Love yeah. it. Yeah. Jeremy, you're the boss. One of those are your own.
It's 100 Australians have chosen. I think I'm going to go with the majority answer.
Yep.
And I'm going to go with Tony Hawk.
I like the process here. Let's see if it gets you the first points. No! Reporters, grab the opening blow. 76, number 6 was... Tricks! Who had that? That was you, Trudy, wasn't it? Hey, well played you. Well played you. Not that it matters right now, but well played you. So 0-76. And if either of these families go on to win for 5 nights in a row, they'll be driving home the brand new Mitsubishi Outlander! This family SUV seats 5 comfortably and is packed with features including touchscreen audio, CVT auto with paddle shift and eco drive support as well. Now, for everybody playing along at home, I want the top answer to this one. Name a place where people often jog. We'll give you the answer when we return after this on The Feud. Two families are still battling it out for that chance at $10,000. Before the break, I asked, name a place where people often jog. The top answer was...
Ha!
Yay! Trudy, Stu, let's play The Feud. You're a gentleman, aren't you? You went all the way around the front just to say a nice little hello.
Trudy and I were born in the same place.
Really?
Hmm. Yes. Almost family.
To the same mother?
Well, you know, we do look quite alike.
Well, this is the show that just really brings everybody together, doesn't it? This is lovely. We could do this all day.
Oh, we could.
Let's. We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name something made out of wood. Stu.
Your house.
Your house could be made out of wood. Pretty.
A chair.
Give me a chair on the board. Chair is good. And there was a chair as well. Nice work. They're going to love it. David.
How are you?
Something made out of wood.
Table. Let's try a table.
Let's try. Ooh. Nice job, Natasha. Something made out of wood.
A boat.
Boat is good. Oh! Oh. So, Jeremy?
Perhaps a piano.
Ah, let's have a look. Second strike. Repartis, time to have a think. Trudy, you're our go-to girl for great answers.
Apparently. Well, Jeremy will attest to 6 years of architecture school, a lot of balsa wood models. So I'm going to say models.
Models?
Yes.
Let's see. 3 strikes. Repartis. Stephanie, what would you say?
I said surfboard.
Tari.
Skateboard.
Stu. Okay. Let it go!
She holds on. Guitar.
Nice. Mike has some wonderful options from the family. Doing the business for you right now, but it's yours to decide.
They're awesome. I'm going to go with furniture.
Did any of them say furniture?
No.
Okay. You're awesome, but I'm ignoring
you.
With
I've got
furniture.
This.
Yes! Great captaining! Number 7.
Door.
Door.
Tree.
Hello! It's made of it. That's where it comes from. In the tree factory. All right, give me David, give me Tari, let's play. We surveyed 100 people and the top 6 answers are on the board. Name something you might use in a science class. Well, that was almost identical, but you were just first.
A beaker?
A beaker. Well, nice. Nearly the top.
Test tube.
Give me test tube. Close. Harry. Pass. Okay.
Right.
In a double points round right now, Natasha. Something you might use in a science class.
A Bunsen burner.
You so would!
Yeah. I've got this one.
Favourite part of going to school is using a Bunsen burner and accidentally nearly setting the school on fire. Yeah. Jeremy.
With that Bunsen burner, you would want some chemicals.
Let's see. Woo. Trudy, you're zero at the moment. They're sitting on 145 over there and looking pretty smug too, I might add. Just knock them out. Two answers to go and you've got this.
I'm not worried.
No.
No,
you're looking at me like you're either really deep in thought or you've got nothing.
I'm deep in thought. I have got something.
Good.
A microscope.
Microscope. Love it. Ha-ha! Nice work.
Pressure.
This is a nice position for you guys to be in right now, David.
Righto. Let's try litmus paper. Litmus paper.
What is that?
Well, I don't know, but it sounds good anyway.
A litmus paper. First strike, that's okay.
Okay.
Tasha?
The periodical table.
Ah, yeah. Of course you do. All the little symbols and words that mean stuff.
Correct. That's the one.
I don't know why I'm not working for NASA. Second strike. Okie dokie. Ropatas, get ready for the steal potentially. Jeremy?
A petri dish.
Petri dish?
Chance.
He looks pretty happy with that.
Yeah. I'm doing.
He's number five to get you guys some double points. A petri dish? No, it's not. Three strikes. Ropatas. You guys have a really nice feeling kind of huddle. It's like a real warm conference in there.
Welcome.
It's almost I want to join.
Come on.
Stephanie.
Roger. I said protective goggles.
Safety first. Love it. Tari.
A white coat.
White coat. Got to have one in the lab.
Yeah, I'm with the protective goggles.
Yep. Micah.
See, they are awesome.
Would you like to ignore them again?
No.
You worked for you last time.
It did.
What are you going to go with?
Number five is protective clothing.
I love this positivity. Let's see if you're right. Oh. Yes, the Huntley's got some points. Congratulations. Taking the one to 78 and gives them the lead. Number five is safety goggles. Oh, man. That's that was right. Stephanie. Yeah. She like said it too. Oh, she even did the symbols, Micah. She even said, come on, man. Righto, if you love Family Feud, then you're going to really love 10 Play, where you can catch all the highlights of the fun bits that we can't fit into the show on air, as well as playing along at home with the official Family Feud game. And to 10 Play, check out Family Feud for all the details. Triple points, and we all come back on this fantastic Monday night on The Feud. Because the Hutton family have just stolen the lead off the Ropatas. It's 145 to 178 and the family gets the 300 points in this round. Could win $10,000 in our fast money round and we're playing for triple points right now. So both teams are still in the running. This is a close one. Natasha, Stephanie, let's play. We surveyed 100 people and the top seven answers are on the board. Name a popular Queensland tourist destination. Natasha.
Gold Coast.
Gold Coast is good. Stephanie, can you get the top answer?
Movie World.
Let's have a look.
Oh, I forgot the question, sorry.
I'm afraid not. So, Natasha, pass or play?
Let's play.
Jeremy, a popular Queensland tourist destination.
Well, I'm going to go with the ever classic, everything's better when it's bigger, the big pineapple.
Of course it is. Nice. It's on the board. Trudy?
Right, well, I've been to Queensland once. So, I'm going to go with the Australia Zoo.
Australia Zoo. Sorry, Trudy.
Davis.
Right. Righto, being a Queenslander, if I get this wrong, I'm in trouble. Let's go the Great Barrier Reef.
Oh, of course! One of the natural wonders of the world. There we are. Tasha?
Yes, I'm going to just go with theme parks.
Good. Just good broad general thinking.
Yep.
Nice. Jeremy, this is looking good. Triple point round right now.
I'm going to go with the Daintree.
The Daintree is also one of the great wonders. Just not on our board. Trudy. That's a second strike. So the Ropatas could steal. They trail right now, and this is a triple point round.
The one time I did go to Queensland...
Yes.
I went to Hamilton Island.
That your answer?
That's my answer.
Let's see. Oh! Sorry, Hutton's Ropatas. This is a great opportunity for you guys right now. Stephanie?
The Hard Rock Cafe.
Tari?
Cairns.
Stu?
Whenever I go to Queensland, I go to Suncorp Stadium.
Do you just?
I do.
Micah, some wonderful options.
Surfers Paradise.
So you reckon Surfers Paradise to get you guys the win in tonight's show and make you our brand new family champions?
Yes, please.
Let's see Surfers Paradise. Congratulations. A great punt by the Ropata family. Number seven. Cairns. Now this is also there. Oh man, Hutton family, you guys played brilliantly, I might add. Trudy, David, Natasha, wonderful to have you here. Look, you didn't become our champs, but you will be taking home a gift card for $1,000 to share between you, courtesy of Proud's the Jewellers, where you'll find great gift ideas for the whole family. And you'll also be taking home our brand new Family Feud board game as well. They're the Hutton family. Please put your hands together. Nice work, guys. Ropata, who's doing fast money? Micah and Stuart.
Yep. All right.
Oh, that was cool.
Was it fun?
You look...
I was terrified.
Yeah, you look like you were terrified. You looked frightened to death the whole way through that. Was it harder than you thought?
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah. Is it just... It's just so much going on?
Yeah.
Are you okay
right
now?
It's your shirt.
Oh, it's my bedazzled shirt. I'm calling it Electro Salmon.
That's the salmon. That's pink, bro. That's pink.
Head over that way to our soundproof booth. You and I play for $10,000 next to the Feud in Fast Money.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Watermelon salmon, definitely. Welcome back. It's Fast Money time here in the Feud. Let's see if the Ropata family can now win some cash. If you and Stu get 200 points or more between you, you will win...
$10,000.
Yeah! And you like the sound of that. Stu is now in our soundproof booth and can't hear your answers. He does dance. Look.
Well, he's sitting down.
He actually dances pretty good.
He's not too bad. From here down.
It's not so good. He's got the man problem. Yeah. Can only do the bloke and shuffle. Can only do that. But up here, it's all busy.
Yeah.
I'm going to ask you 5 questions. Going to give you 20 seconds to answer, OK? Now, if you pass, we'll come back if there's time. And the clock starts at the end of the very first question. So, are you ready?
Yeah.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Best of luck. Name something you wrap in newspaper.
Presents.
Name something you do at a football match.
Cheer.
Name something you always run out of in the bathroom.
Toilet paper.
Name something people use to scare burglars away.
Softball bats.
Name a ferocious animal that looks cuddly.
Tiger.
Love it. Good job. Happy?
Yeah.
Let's go. So how was your first attempt at Fast Money?
It was awesome.
Cool. You did a good job. Name something you wrap in newspaper. You said presents.
Come on, you got this.
I don't know how to tell you this, but your presents suck. Imagine receiving that as a gift. Happy birthday. Oh, you bothered to wrap it in newspaper.
What if you don't have any gift wrap?
I see. Well, you're kind of, yeah, improvising.
Yeah.
Does Australia agree?
Yes.
Computer says no. Name something you do at a football match, you said. You cheer. Survey says. Great job. Something you always run out of in the bathroom, you said. Toilet paper, survey says. Yes, another great result. Name something people use to scare burglars away. You said, specifically, a softball bat. Why not a cricket bat?
Because softball's metal, they're harder. Mm. You know, baseball bats are made out of wood.
Yeah.
I play softball.
How much damage are you hoping to inflict?
They're burglaring my house.
Get away, burglarizers, survey says. Sorry. A ferocious animal that looks cuddly, you said.
Tiger.
You like tigers, do you?
The West Tigers. Ah. Love you, Benji.
Hope he's listening. Survey says... 15. Great job. 92 is about spot on. So well done. Head back to Sandy Beautiful.
That's not too bad. You talked yourself down, but I liked what I saw.
I had a patented move.
I liked what I saw.
You did? Mm. We can do that sometime.
Maybe we could.
Yeah, we can.
If you're $10,000 richer, take me on a date. Let's see. I'm going to ask you the same five questions, but you're the second player, and it's a little harder, so I'll give you an extra 5 seconds, OK? If you pass on a question, I'll ask it again if there's time, and if you repeat an answer that's already there, you'll hear this sound, and I'll ask you to try again.
Beautiful.
Can we remind everybody of Micah's answers? And 25 seconds on the clock too, please. The time starts from the end of the first question, mate. Good luck. Name something you wrap in newspaper.
Fish and chips.
Name something you do at a football match.
Cheer.
Try again.
Pass.
Name something you always run out of in the bathroom.
Shampoo.
Name something people use to scare burglars away.
An alarm.
Name a ferocious animal that looks cuddly.
Tiger.
Try again.
Lion.
Name something you do at a football match.
Watch the game.
Excellent. Hey, great job. Good. Let's go. That was pretty good. Not too bad. Name something you wrap in a newspaper. Now, we knew we had a New Zealander come on, so we thought we'd ask this question just so we could hear you say...
Fish and chips.
He says it funny.
Six pieces of fish.
Don't hit me, Stu.
No, no.
Survey says... Hey, guess what? That was the top answer, my man. Well done. Name something you do at a football match. You said... You'd watch the game. The survey says... Oh, man. Micah had cheer, the top
Nobody
answer.
The game.
Name something you always run out of in the bathroom. You said shampoo. Really?
Always. Whenever I need some, there's never any there.
Survey says 14. Now, toilet paper was the top answer. Well done, Micah. Name something people use to scare burglars away. You said. Alarm. Now, the good news is it's the top answer.
Yes!
Well done! Oh! That's awesome.
I'm loving it.
You're going really well now. So 23 is all we need from this last answer to get you guys $10,000. This is right within striking distance. Name a ferocious animal that looks cuddly. You said. Are you not sure about that answer?
No, I threw it out there. I thought I was done and dusted after the other four, so...
But look how well you've actually gone. Have you gone better than you thought you would?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
That's a brilliant performance. We need 23 or more from this final answer to give you $10,000 right now. You ready? The survey says... Stick around, the project's coming up right now on 10. It's news for all the family. We'll see you tomorrow night. I'm Grant Denyer. Good night, Australia.